the safety of women in this place, of female staff, of female MPs and senators should be above politics.
Another female politician fed up, but this time the barbs are directed at the other side of politics.
Well, I say to the Leader of the Opposition, I will not be lectured by you.
Liberal MP Nicole Flint slamming Labor for not speaking out against ALP, union and Get Up supporters who, she says, harassed her during the 2019 election campaign, claims Get Up denies.
What I say to the Labor Party today is they may not have held the spray can to vandalise my office with sexist slurs. They may not have held the camera pointed at me by the stalker, but they did create the environment in which hate could flourish.
She endured one of the ugliest campaigns I've ever seen waged against not just a woman, but anyone.
Last year, Flint called out media commentary around her appearance.
What should a woman in politics wear? How about a garbage bag to match your rubbish views?
Announcing plans to quit politics last month. Now she's dropping bombs on her way out.
I say to the Leader of the Opposition, get your own house in order.
Flint singling out some of Labor's most senior women for standing idly by.
What Ms. Flint reports as having happened to her is utterly unacceptable. It is also unfair of her to seek to tie me and Tanya Plibersek to it.
Notably absent, though, any criticism of Flint's own party's treatment of women.
I think it's a political comment from Nicole Flint. The fact is that in terms of inappropriate behaviour, I call it out whenever I'm asked to do so. Nicole Flint was subject to very bad behaviour and that shouldn't have happened.
Rather than making these sorts of accusations in public, let's have a discussion about how we can work to improve the situation for all women.
This can't be about politics anymore. We all bear the responsibility for change.
We invited Nicole Flint, Penny Wong, Tanya Plibersek and Anthony Albanese on tonight's show, but they all declined.
Her speech aside, what was interesting was a Facebook page of Labor alumni today saying they know stories within the Labor Party, some of the men they saw at the marches, they say, we know you're doing a different thing in private. We don't know the specifics of that. But if that were to catch on and become a thing, and this stopped being about a couple of senior politicians just on the coalition side, do you think that would be good or bad for the movement?
Well, perhaps if the spotlight was just on all of them, then they have no choice but to clean up their act, that it's just a wake-up call across the board.
Yeah.
But when we were talking about this today, you were saying that the complete opposite could happen, which is just devastating to think,
really.
Well,
they close ranks because they've got a common thing to protect.
Yeah.
I just
feel like we have to keep up the momentum. Mm. We really do.
Yep.
Yeah. With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.